your people listening from every corner of this planet. No knowledge has been dispersed so beautifully, so balanced across the planet, this planet ever, maybe in the universe. You have the full potential of achieving everything in the universe. There is no need and there is no reason for man not to achieve. So, wherever you are, the way I taught you to make the coils double coil inside, you have continuous eco gravitational magnetic field, and if you put CO2 on it, and you put zinc on it, you have connected the emotion of the man to it on a stable condition, and you'll find out you become a very peaceful man. Here, instead of having galaxies and universes and creating connection magnetically, we have used the matter state gravitational magnetic field strength to dominate and dictate the shape of the plasma. The nano technology, the nanomaterial which you have collectively developed in different ways by caustic, by electric currents, by whatever, fire or whatever, has that advantage that the matter, the nano and the plasma is all the same. So connection is very solid, it's very strong. The power of the plasma technology, the way we have thought, is beyond imagination of the man. Now we can create and control the plasma, which is the mother of the creation of the universe. We are given the seed of the essence of the creation. The foundation does not belong to no one and is not made of one anymore. You are developing it, you are structuring it, and from today, we will be still the same. We'll still develop the technology in different names, in different colors, in different nationalities, which they do not exist. It is beautiful when we see the Christian, the Muslims, the Jews, and every other belief are working together to build up systems. We have already become one faith. We already have become one nation, and we already become one planet. You got to remember one thing. Dates is irrelevant. Today is the last day of the Christian calendar, or tomorrow is the beginning of another. One day is connected to another. We don't stop. We are working around the clock. The Keshe Foundation team is working irrespective of time, position, religion, country. And now we achieve what we set out for.
The Universal Council invites you to attend the One Planet, One Nation, One Race event in Rome on the 9th and 10th of September 2016. The Council looks forward to open interaction with the public at the event. Come interact with the Council in your spoken language. The Council encourages you to bring your positive suggestions and solutions to the table on how humanity can move forward as a whole towards everlasting peace. In this way, the work of the members of the Council will become the work of humanity for humanity. The full package price for a single ticket to the event includes 3-night stay in one of Rome's prestigious hotels, daily attendance to the event, as well as breakfast on the 9th through the 11th, and lunch and tea on the 9th and 10th. Accommodations for this package is based on double occupancy. The full package price for 2 tickets to the event includes 3-night stay in a twin bed room in one of Rome's prestigious hotels, daily attendance to the event, as well as breakfast on the 9th through the 11th, and lunch and tea on the 9th and 10th. Additional nights stay are offered at €150 per person per night. For those who wish to arrange their own accommodations and who plan on attending a single day of the event, the cost will be €200, which includes tea and lunch on the day of the event. For those who wish to arrange their own accommodations and who plan on attending both days of the event, the cost will be €400, which includes tea and lunch on the day of the event. The One Planet, One Nation, One Race event in Rome. Come share your positive solutions on how we can work together to bring everlasting peace to our world.
Welcome, everyone, to the 115th Knowledge Seekers Workshop, the Keshe Foundation Spaceship Institute. It's May 25th, 2016, and once again, we find ourselves here gathered to listen to the teachings of the Keshe Foundation through Mr. Keshe, who's looks like he's ready to go, according to our screen here. Mr. Keshe, are you ready there today for some activities? We have a small presentation from Stephen Zhang with a new type of medical unit, and I'm not sure what you have lined up for today, and as usual, I'm sure many things will pop up. Go ahead.
Yes, good morning. Good afternoon, good day to you, as usual, wherever and whenever you listen to these teachings. As we've seen, the teaching now has moved into a new phase of space technology, and in the coming time, you will see the development of the space technology in its true sense, where in the space we travel with gravitational field forces, that we don't float and we don't in a way become not being in control of our own physical behavior as we see in the space travels of today. As part of the program of the Keshe Foundation, as we said, the Rome event is looming up and we are setting ready for it. And at the same time, the Mojans program is behind the scene, developing its own way, and we'll see in the coming time as people join in. There are a number of announcements we have to make, which is usually we do. The most important one is that this announcement directs and is towards the China, Chinese people, Chinese Keshe Foundation and Chinese leadership. We make it very clear. The Chinese leadership has appointed Professor Zhu of USPC to be the direct connection between the Keshe Foundation and the government and military. From today, we accept and respectively, we appoint Professor Zhu to be the representative and the head of the Keshe Foundation in China. As Chinese organization, laboratories, and different organizations come to work together, there is a need to bring, as we said some times ago, the work of the Keshe Foundation in line and work in conjunction with the government's wishes of the nation. So, we accept the appointment of Professor Zhu as the head of the Keshe Foundation in China, and we respond positively to requests and appointment of Professor Zhu by the central government. All the Chinese groups in China, all the 7-8 labs, plus the groups which are working in the background, the development of the new GANs with the funding which has been received for up to 2 tons a day. We support and we approve, and at the same time, all the work of the Keshe Foundation in China from today is handed over to Professor Zhu at USBC. At the same time, as he is a professor in the university, he becomes the head of the Keshe Foundation in China. In due time, as we merge the work of the laboratories and the Keshe Foundations in China with the work of the government and the need of the government, the position becomes very apparent. It will be a very powerful position where the science, the technology and the wishes of the government of the Keshe Foundation and the Chinese government come together. This is important. We were requested to respond today and we respond accordingly. On the other hand, all developments from now on and to my travel to China in the next few weeks will be coordinated and is in hand of Professor Zhu, and Professor Zhu will confirm everything to be done in China through his office. He is professor as we said, USBC, and Professor Zhu will deliver, and all the works of the Keshe Foundations in China has to go through him and no other channel. We bring all the sites, different laboratories, work of the Keshe Foundation, the commercialization, the development, and especially the new funding for production of the 2 tons of what you call GANs material per day, as is planned, will be headed by him. And I thank Professor Zhu in accepting the position. On the other hand, today as we talk, tests are going in Japan, which will allow us, hopefully next week or two, to confirm the work and delivery of the what we call materials in Japan for decontamination and every other application of the GANs material into Japanese society on the back of the development of the what we had with TEPCO. Now we bring it, hopefully today, but the next 2-3 days, in collaboration with a well-known establishment in Japan, into the market where Japanese can be benefited by the same technology as TEPCO has been. The important point for us is to carry on with the development. We have taught a lot in the space technology. We have taught a lot in respect to the development of the reactors which can be used for the space. This is important to the team of Professor Zhu in, that's how his name is spelled. He is a professor at USBC and appointed by the Chinese leadership to head us, and his team, 7-8 team laboratory group which are working with him, is important for you to understand this very, very carefully. It's part of the development you're producing, and our teaching goes directly into the Chinese infrastructure of the scientists who work in the background with the Keshe Foundation. In the reactors you are developing for a space, as we explained, in the rotation of the systems, where we taught you last week, you can connect in a way that the rotation of the coil and the rotation of the core can produce interaction between the fields, which creates the condition of the motion and lift. In this condition, in a space, we do not have motors, we do not see engines. Here, part of the advantage of working on Earth knowledge and technology, man has created himself motors. We adjust these with motors as we done. But in space, how do we create motion? How do we create motion of the plasma that in the interaction of the field plasmas, when the difference is large enough, leads to friction or at the end leads to the physical motion and rotation? We have a number of choices. We can create gravitational magnetic field plates, where on these plates, all you need to do, you place ganses of different strength in different positions that field flow in the fields of different plates creates rotation of the what you like to be in the center of your reactors. If you look at this in a top view, our Chinese friends, you are developing this. Please understand this very carefully. This is the next step in control of plasmatic condition of fields, what we call the field plasma, not liquid plasma or a vapor plasma. When you are developing and you're at a stage to develop this condition for your Oasis system, using the mass amount of ganses which are now commissioned to be produced, this is important to understand what kind of ganses you need to produce. That the investments which is set for Oasis in the space is used appropriately. Producing mass amount of gans without a clear direction from the beginning is exactly what we are not heading for. If you look at this, at two plates, this is the other plate. Remember, in the space technology, you always feed from the strongest field strength to the lowest field strength. And if you can create a condition of the rotation of the fields through the plasmatic, what we call radiation of fields, you achieve a constant flow and you achieve a constant dictating the condition and the speed of the rotation of the plasma without physically moving anything in your reactor cores. Placing in different orders your very much like the patches you made of different material in different position will give you a lot of rotation without actually doing any physical motion of your plates. As the fields you can introduce or withdraw, try to feed. You go from, let's say, the highest order strength to the lowest. In trying to catch up, they create a field flow. You don't need motors. You don't need engines. the whole purpose of the new, what we call field plasma, is to introduce and apply plasma technology without motors, the way the universe works. So it is important in the upcoming work, especially with the Chinese government, the scientists who work around us to understand this, that this is the step towards the space technology without depending on motors which can fail, breakdowns, and the failures of system. In space, if you understand the interaction of the fields, you understand there is no need for motors, there is no need for physical systems, even physical reactors, to contain the plasma and its motion. If you see, I've drawn a field in pink, I have not drawn a core. In space, you can dictate the parameters where the solid state stays and where is maintained. Look at the structure of the surface of this planet. It's the interaction of the fields which decides where you have the solid state matter of the continents and where the liquid states of the oceans stay. At the same time, the interaction of the fields in the inner sanctum of the planet and in interaction with the field within the plasma of the solar system besides the thickness of what we call the atmosphere of this planet. There is no mechanism to hold the oxygen or the hydrogen or the gases except by the interaction of the field. So, going into the field plasma technology, this is the next step, which is containment by fields and not by matter condition. As man is the materialistic and is connected to the matter state, we went through the whole stage from molecular structure to atomic to plasmatic. Now we enter the field of the technology the same as is in the universe. If you look at the structure of the galaxies, you see they all have different shapes and forms, and we see the boundaries of it. These shapes and forms are only created by the interaction of the fields of the stars and the systems within the galaxies, and the interaction with the fields and what is in the environment of the universe around them, dictate their shape, dictate their color, dictate their flatness. And now you see the shape of a galaxy without the containment, and this is where the field plasma technology goes. In a space, you cannot go and look for copper to make a core, but you can create a condition from interaction of the fields that gives you the confinement of the plasma within the atmosphere of your system without actually ever having a physical matter structure. This way, in a space, you never look for materials to create things. You look for the interaction of the fields to maintain, to develop, and to operate and use different field forces in a given condition for the development and for the structure of your systems. If you understand this, you will understand the reason why. As I've explained before, at the moment, you are producing copper coils, you're producing crystal cores. What happens when you enter in a space, somewhere in the galaxy, somewhere in the universe, where the copper state of the matter is the field plasma strength of the environment. You lose your reactor. You lose your life. You lose your spaceship, because now the plasma cannot be contained. It's very much, if you understand it, you have an ice in the freezer, you bring it in the heat of the summer, and it melts. It has no shape, it changes its behavior. In space, in different gravitational magnetic fields, you understand that matter state, which you up to now have followed, becomes troublesome. Because one second you have a core, next second you don't have a core, because your core strength matter state has happened to mix and be the same as its environment. This is what goes back in the understanding of the containment as the skin of the man. You create interaction of the field plasmas, where the layers of plasma gives the manifestation of the physicality. But because you have used different strength, field strength, and is a dynamic state, as the field changes, the field strength rotation changes, you maintain your skin. We go in the water, we don't melt. We go in the heat of the summer, we don't melt. Because our body has accepted a field transfer of a limitation of environmental, magnetic, gravitational field variation. So, in space, you have to have the same condition, where your reactors stays at the minimum condition of the existence of the man, which is your amino acid, and operates and maintains a shell of fields and not matter state, to create the condition and maintaining the position in respect to the core system which has created itself. So, what you need to do, and what you come to understand, is you use a spectrum of plasmatic gravitational magnetic fields, which their interaction in the positions you have predetermined dictates the speed of the rotation, the field strength, and at the same time, the positioning of its field in respect to its environment. Field plasma is the ultimate step in space technology. And our Chinese friends are achieving and targeting in that direction with the help of the government. And we are there to support and bring other nations in line with where the Chinese are heading. It is important to realize, as you play with different gears in a gearbox, in a mechanical system, in a motor system, in a space technology, you play with the field strength of different dimensions. That it allows you to create a condition of rotation, positioning, and even physical interaction to create a physical condition to maintain and contain matter state. If you understand this step, then very simply, now that you produced the liquid gans, liquid plasma, Now it should be very easy to manipulate the liquid plasma to produce field plasma. You can direct it, you can target it, you can control the speed of it by the amount of it. You have to understand it works by the mass, gravitational, magnetic, plasmatic mass, which decides not by the volume. Now you have to start becoming masters of how to mix different gases, different plasmatic liquid gases to create the strength which you need and how you can withdraw and add to. This I started speaking about in past couple of weeks. Some of you understood. Government scientists have jumped on it. They are running with it like crazy because they receive the key into the universal motion and understand it. What it means, if you remember, we went through it like we looked at Mercury, we looked at lead, we looked at the atomic mass of gold and silver. You cannot mix these materials in a physical matter state, it's an impossibility. But you can create the gans of them and then create a plasmatic field, liquid plasma of them, and then with you have the freedom to play the game of the universe through the field which is released by plasmatic liquid. Maybe now you understand why I brought you in this path, that you slowly understand the work of the universe. It was hard to produce the plasmatic field from a matter state. We nano-coated it, we separated it, made the gans of it. In the gans, we brought it to its liquid state, and now we understand final play. You play with the field of it. In this state of alloys, there are certain materials to never mix. You cannot mix mercury with copper and lead and gold. You cannot do with the other materials. But if you make a nanomaterial of it, make a gans of it, make the liquid of it, in the liquid plasma you have the field of it, and the interaction of the fields gives you everything you could imagine to create. This is in the writing of Baha'u'llah's name, and the man understand the mutation of the elements. And now you understand. Then the man achieved the maturity of his intellect. So, now you see how we have come, because now you can do exactly the same in reverse. Now that you have the plasmatic field, you can go down to... Now the cycle is complete. You can create field winds, you can create hurricanes without moving your finger. You can create waves that it sounds love and sweetness, and you can create oceans of winds in the condition of traveling across the universe at the speed of the universe itself. That's the point when there is no time and no space. this is more or less the ultimate position of science of universe. It's for you to start learning how to manipulate, how to complete. I have taught you in past 2 years, step by step, as you understood more and more and more. And now, the plasma technology, in its field plasma transfer, is more or less the ultimate. There is a couple of more steps after the field plasma, but the knowledge of man will take millions of years to understand. It's beyond the intelligence of the man at the present time. But this gives you sufficient enough knowledge to be able to create systems, materials, not only to enter the universe, enter the universal community, but to give man every opportunity to create whatever he needs on this planet that stops the cause of war, conflict and superiority of one man on the others. Because every single man can produce whatever he needs when he needs. He does not become a slave to the hand of the demand of his physical existence. If you understand the process, if you understand the gravity of the knowledge which is released today, you understand, you have reached the point that man can fly, can be at any point in the universe as he wishes, and there is no need for colors, races and nations, because now your problem is not becoming from a village to a nation and to a planet. Now you have billions of planetarians which are part of universal community, and they all have and carry this knowledge. Man has been left behind because of his own ignorance and his violence behavior, and now it's completed. This way you create motion within the plasma, within the fields of the plasma, that you can decide the speed of the interaction. And then, even on the disk of the field, as you see in different colors, you can predetermine, this is the boundary of the fields I want to be outside, and what I want to be inside. So, in so many ways, if you understand, it's very easy to create plasmatic conditions of layering in sequences. That, for example, if you make another setup here, and you make all of this, let's have a copper strength, in this state of planet, your reactor will have a copper strength. But because it's plasmatic, it can change itself to another according to the pressure of the environment. You never lose your containment of the field. You see, solid state in matters in the universe on planets made of whatever material which is not available. This is how it's done. This is how now, with man having the versatility of the use of the plasmatic field, that he can dominate, interact, develop and create conditions that he works in a safe environment. Scale this knowledge up, scale this knowledge down. Scale it up, you can travel the universe in no time. Scale it down, you can create in the outer ring the condition, the shape of the kidney of the man which has failed in operation. You dictate the parameters around the kidney with your system outside the body, and then you create field forces inside that allows work of the kidney, sets parameters. You do not need to remove the kidney of a man or look for somebody who is desperate for money to sell his kidney somewhere in Istanbul. You can dictate where you want to grow a tissue in the heart where a child is born with a hole in his heart, without losing the child. You can do the same if you understand this process, how to use field forces to do remote, no-touch surgeries. Scale it further up, you can produce the fruits and the shape and the color of the banana you like. Now, the mutation is in the hand of the intelligence of the man. And how you use it, how you apply it, how you bring it together in a way that does not harm you and does not change the condition to harm others in the environment which you exist. By creating plasmatic gravitational magnetic field tolerances, you accept a certain condition within that tolerance with a field strength matter condition. Now, you can see how field plasma can lead to production of matter state as you wish, the way you want, and the creation of the conditions that while the system is working, as our Chinese friends are heading to production of the mass production of the Oasis systems, the field plasmas, they choose, will dictate if within the containment, energy fields of water is created, energy fields of food is created, without actually passengers or the people which are using the Oasis system ever think of ever drinking or having a need for food. As it becomes part of the structure of the plasma of their body and they absorb from the environment of the what they call Oasis, what they need. In the reality, all you need to do, you create a base at the bottom and a base on the top, and itself, in transfer of the plasma, creates its own field condition. And as your body is set in the structure of the GANS state, you can travel through and in and out. And the matter state, you decide what the barrier to be, according to the field strength you use. You want it to be in a gaseous state resistance, as on the surface of the earth, or you want it to be in a liquid state in the bottom of the ocean. You want to travel in deepest, what you call part of the universe, which there is no fields, but you dictate you can operate in those loose, weak field points, or you want to point to the center of the star and exist and have an excursion to see how it'll be. Now, the knowledge is getting us to completion. It's you who have to understand how to manipulate the field forces of the plasmas, the GANSes, and then the liquid plasma which you have created. You need to move into liquid plasma, that you can move into the field plasma. It's a condition which needs understanding, and it takes very little, very short time for those who understood the process of the plasmatic gravitational field, the strength of the plasmas they've created, to move on into the next step. As I said many times in the past few weeks, the speed of teaching goes so fast that there is no time. And each one of you will take from the table of knowledge according to your intelligence. And the point you cannot understand, you oppose it. And this is the behavior of the man. Or when you understand a little of it, you claim to be the whole of it. We've seen this in many people who come around the foundation. But our knowledge is free. You can claim whatever you like, as the knowledge was dispersed through this foundation and is the foundation of humanity. So, according to your weakness and strength, you can claim and do whatever you like. But as long as your work brings peace to mankind, that's the object of the foundation. Any questions?
Thank you, Mr. Keshe. We'll check in the various places here. We have a viewer with his hand up. Any panelists that have any questions, you might want to open your microphone and go ahead. Or if you're a viewer, you can put your hand up and I can promote the list. And I'll check on the live stream as well. Hello?
Hello, Mario, you're from Germany. I have a question. What is exactly the difference between the liquid plasma fields and the, if you combine two different ganses, is it that if you combine two different ganses that you have still have the separate fields, and if you use the liquid plasma in water, then it's a combined field, as you explained before, like a new kind of material that doesn't exist in matter state? Or what exactly is the difference in field strength?
You explained it very nicely in your last sentence. If you look at the gans state, when you mix ganses, they still stay gravitational magnetic field position in respect to each other. Because they carry different structure. When you have we've shown this clearly in the picture in book number 2, in where we've shown the ganses. I try to go to one side where we have room. When you have the gans of, for example, copper, or you have the gans of another material, even though they're in a containment, in a box, in a glass, if you look at them, they are still positioned in respect to each other. Because the central position, the central gravitational magnetic field is different. When you go into the liquid plasma, now you have the same in origin. So the gapping, the distancing is constant. All you've done, you have created a condition of overloading the same plasma with different strength, which this radiates equal according to the mass into the environment which is released. This is the homogeneity of the plasma you create. In gas state, you have positioning. In a liquid state, you don't, but you have the field strength release, which is, this is what you're looking for. And each field in interaction will interact with its own. So it's the freedom which you do not have. Here you create a spectrum interaction. Here you do not. You work on a very much same level, but within the structure of the same atomic mass.
Thank you, that makes it clear to me.
Thank you very much. Sit back. I lose my mic. I'm getting adjusted. Okay, that's good. Thank you very much. Any other question?
There's a question from Jay. Will China produce different types of GANSes and research into uses of other GANSes also?
Yes, in China, we are fully committed to the full production of all the aspects of the Keshe Foundation technology. It's a commitment by the organization, by the government, and by the universities. We are built, and we will build as part of the structure of the university's teaching and all the scientific developments. Chinese government has committed itself to peace, and the peace has come through the new technology and the knowledge, and we respect that. And they have financially positioned themselves to support different developments, and they've appointed leading scientists in the country to take and collaborate to bring technology to its highest level. And today, we announced that every one of the top scientists in the country, one of the top universities in the country, and if you look, President Xi was in this university a matter of 2 or 3 weeks ago. We announced the establishment of different sections of the Keshe Foundation university structure in the coming weeks. It's got to be done by the government and not by the Keshe Foundation. That's what we said. The collaboration of the Keshe Foundation and governments has started in a very rapid way. We've seen it in Ghana with the Atomic Commission. We see, as I was talking to Armand this morning, United States government is moving through the same path as we understand, now that the Chinese have moved. And we see the same thing in collaboration in Russia. As I explained to you, the technology is credibility understood by the leading scientists and is taking its own shape. China will lead the space technology, the spaceship program. China will lead through production of new energy system, and China will lead in production of food and peaceful application of the technology in the coming days. We could work very closely. We have appointed people, appointed by them, we trust, and respectively we work through the same. In so many ways, as I said before, we thank President Xi for his, what I call clear decision making in bringing humanity to peace and taking the leadership in using the technology for a peaceful application.
Mr. Keshe, do you want me to show the, there's a Chinese medical unit, and they have a question about the copper versus aluminum wire used in it.
Yes, why not? Sure. Are they online? They can explain it themselves.
I asked if Stephen Zhang would like to speak about it, and he declined. I think he's a bit shy, so he wanted me to present it. It's a pretty.
Let me explain something before you go. When we arrive in China in the coming days, the teaching of the Keshe Foundation will be directly targeted at the Keshe Foundation supporters and the scientists who understand and work around the foundation. There's thousands of them. So all the teaching will be translated simultaneously in Chinese. We start teaching live in the institutes and universities, which will not be released in the West. So the teaching while we're in China is targeted for the scientists. If you're a Chinese, you're too shy to speak English, or you think you don't understand, when we are in China, everything will be totally in Chinese. Teachings, the developments, the live teachings will be all in Chinese, translated in Chinese, will be done for the Chinese nationals. So this problem of language will be taken away. This is a process which is setting up by Professor Zhu, that other Keshe Foundation supporters, everything will be totally in Chinese. So the collaboration will be very fine. We don't have this language barrier. I cannot learn Chinese, but we can teach very rapidly what we can in the time we stay in China. We expect to be in China over 6 months, at least maybe 3, 6 to a year to develop fully everything, all aspects with the Chinese government. Carry on.
Okay, let me do a screen share when I get this set up. Just a second here. Can you see that?
Yeah. Can you open it up?
Okay, I'll try to make it a bigger.
There are two parts, six crosses.
Yeah, just a second here. There we go. That's a bit too big. I have to take it a bit smaller.
Hmm.
Almost there. There we go.
Okay. Yeah. It says introduction. There are two parts and six cross-shaped spring units per part. What does this mean?
So this is the one part here with the six units, and the part over here with six units. All right, so in part one, he mentions the inner circles, that would be the horizontal ones, are nano-coated copper.
Yeah, I can see that. And the other one is copper outside, aluminum inside.
Yes, exactly.
Okay. Go further up. The spring unit is connected with two plasma battery capacitors.
Each cross spring unit is connected with two plasma batteries.
Inner circuit, nano coated wire, outer circuit, nano copper wire. Okay, so we see that. What is the next?
He says all the springs are covered with CO2 GANs.
Yeah.
All the springs in the hat use nano zinc line, I think wire, I guess, coated with CO2 GANs.
They use zinc for the helmet, they use copper and aluminium for the body parts, yeah?
So, we test the combination, they say the magnetic flow of the device is stronger than the nano copper wires device, so we don't use the wire to connect the two parts. So the question comes in, the combination of nano copper wire, aluminum wire, and nano zinc wire is proper? And is it necessary to use the nano wire to connect the two parts?
It is not necessary, but it is essential. It is not necessary, but it's better to do it because you target the point of the interaction of the fields. When you don't connect it, the fields interact where whatever they want to interact. When you put the nano line, nano coated, GANs coated wires, you dictate where you want it to go. It's like you want to go from, let's say, from London to New York. You know you're going to New York. You can directly with a ship, you can go with a plane, you can even swim it single-handedly if you can do it. But the point is, you need to create a line. If I go from here to there, I want to go through this line. If I want to go from here to there, I want it to be that line. You find you lose some, but what you receive at a point of interaction between the two sides of the plates, the helmet and the plates, is targeted. This is the reason we use nanowire connections to targeting, to directing the fields which are in that area work differently. When you don't have it, the field spreads open, and whatever interacts, the fields are stronger. But now, when you narrow it with the nano-coated material, you direct it, you position it. That's the reason we do it. Any of your system which you use for medical application. It's especially it's important to understand this. Just because you can make it, does not mean is needed. We chose the copper, we chose the zinc, for a specific structure reason of the body of the man. Aluminium behavior in the field transfer is different. You can use any metal to make a coil up, but understand the field plasma which dictates its flow, what energies will bring or take or add to the structure of the other plasma gas materials. We've seen in the other parts, you can connect different materials, can use the GANs. You can now, if you understood the field transfer, you can build systems which none of these is needed. But this is where we are, this is how we choose to do. But avoid using aluminium coils, especially aluminium coil. If you understand the problem, I explain to you how it works in the body of man, especially in a very minute structure, which changes the field plasma. Years ago, going back 30, 40 years ago, United Nations made it even illegal to do, where there was a drought, planes used to fly, they still do it in some cases, but they think the governments won't find out. They fly high altitude into the high moisture level of the upper atmosphere, or what you call near the planet, 2, 3, 10 kilometers, whatever it is, and they dispersed aluminium dust particles. The moisture sticks to it, and suddenly out of nowhere, in the middle of the heat of the day, you get a massive rain, because the moisture different created rain. But in that process, then we found out the aluminium particles digested by the body of the man can create a lot of problem, health problems. Because when you have it in minute, when it goes in the body, it gets digested, it becomes a gas of aluminium, and it can create and interact different conditions. So, please avoid using aluminium. Let me explain to you something now, this has come up. Maybe we can teach a little bit different way. Can I have the whiteboard back, please? I want to teach you something, because you brought this up, we just add to the knowledge. In the medical application, in a health application, when you look, or in a food digestion, when we say this is the mouth of the man, and you eat, and it goes into your intestine, and this is the, what do you call, the body, whatever, I'm not a very good drawer, but it's good enough. When you digest a food in a matter state, as it goes down at a point of entry in the mouth, as we said before, it changes its matter state and it becomes into the gas state. In entering the stomach, the matter state start changing to nanomaterial first, through what you call the acids, which are actually a conversion plasma condition matter, into a gas state. And then when they reach a certain level of the gas state, the body transfers into the intestine. At this point of intestine, energies, gravitational, plasmatic, magnetic field, which is needed by the body, is released into the lymph. But don't forget, instantaneous, zero time communication, the needs and the collaboration between the brain, fields and the body parts. So, when you digest the food, when it changes to a gas and becomes its plasmatic field plasma, which transfers across the body into the lymph. Then, at this point, what is requested by the brain, because it knows what's going to happen, and the cell allows the withdrawal of the energy from the lymph. This is, for those of you who understood, is very important, because then you understand the energy to be absorbed from the food is predetermined by the brain and the need by the cell. When it crosses and it converts into the field plasma, is already predestined for where it's going and is already targeted to be delivered. If you go back into the health teachings, which we did last year with Dr. Elio Kostova, we touched on this section very clearly on the digestion system, on the walls of the intestine, where we explain no matter ever crosses the wall of the intestine. It's the energy, it's a plasmatic magnetic field which crosses the intestine wall and transfers its energy to the lymph. This was the very first time, and in many teachings I kept on explaining this, we spoke about the field plasma. Only fields of the GANS within the intestine, which have changed from matter to the nano to the GANS, now release their energy according to what is already predetermined by the cell needed and by the brain that it might need or have a need for in the body. And what is needed and done is taken from the digestion system to cross the wall. Otherwise, the food you eat, all the energy crosses straight away into the lymph, and the lymph will be a mess of everything. It's predetermined through gravitational magnetic field strength between the brain and the cell. If it's a cell of a heart, if it's a cell of a piece of a bone, it's a cell of a liver. All predetermined what to be taken from the food. And those which is not there is predetermined by your pituitary glands. I take this surplus because I can convert it using phosphate and sulfur. So you understand even how, if you look in the structure of the body of the man, in certain position of the body, they are even lead. You find very, very minute amount of similar gravitational magnetic field of strength of the lead in the kidney, in the liver, and in the large intestine. Because this is a point where the field pull to separate what is not needed, and the pulling can only come through higher level material. And aluminium plays a very tricky point when it comes to pull the energy, because its imbalance transfer is very similar in energy to energy which is used in certain part of the brain of the man, and interferes with intellect. With the intellect strength of the body of the man, in the brain strength, don't forget, go back into the teaching, go back into the understanding of the past. Pain has a specific gravitational magnetic field strength. Intellect is the same. Comprehension is the same. Aluminium creates a specific field which is in the bandwidth of the intellect and depression. That's why you don't use aluminium. Because now that you have created aluminium field forces in your coils, you make this free into the digestion system and accordingly with the brain. What happened? Oh, I'm getting fiddled with and it says, please go on. What are you doing in my pocket? It's making noise. Yeah, because you keep on moving it. It's too loose, you have to bring it a little bit lower. It's too high. This is good. Okay, I'll try not to. Yeah. So, you understand the reason why you can't use aluminium? Because
would it be a better solution to use silver instead of aluminium?
Pardon?
Would it be a better solution to use silver? Silver coils?
Then you got to understand, you got to use what the body is used to. You cannot create, you see, when you have these the structures which you put the body in, and you have put in the aluminium, now you make the field of aluminium available, more than is needed in the body.
What about in the MagRab units, Mr. Keshe? There's a question that can somebody has already made up aluminum coils for the for some MagRabs. Would that be okay, or is that going to be?
Yeah, you can use it, but when you apply it for the body, you have to understand what it does. This system is targeting for health use. It's targeting
right. Exactly.
The as we say in English, the horses for courses.
Mm-hmm.
Well, and as we say, as I said many times in Farsi, we say, whoever has a mustache is not your uncle, just because he's got a mustache. Just because you made it, you don't need to use it, huh?
And, but the coils that were made for this health unit, could they be repurposed for MagRab units, perhaps?
You can use it for the space technology.
Mm, okay, good.
You can use it for different application, but do not. And you see that now we can explain this very easy because over the past 2-3 years we taught everything. All you need is to go to archives, you understand, every bit comes together one way. We spoke about the transfer of the gravitational magnetic field plasma from intestine into the lymph from the first weeks. Now you understand it, that time could not be understood. Taking 2 years for what is already discussed 2 years ago. To see it. And then you have to understand even what is important in the digestion system for our doctor team who sit in the background. Each section of intestine has different strength and is trained, is been developed to absorb different field strength. You don't absorb your vitamin C all the way along. Your vitamin C is absorbed in a given section of intestine. Then you have a section which only absorbs and allows the release of the field from intestine into the plasma of the lymph of, let's say, red meat and its composite, or of nickel or whatever. So the whole structure, because it is dynamic, it goes back to the depth of the teaching. If you understood it, it's very easy. Each layer, the stomach has exactly the same 3 layers as your skin. And difference in the strength of each layer decides what is released from the GANS plasma inside the intestine going through into the lymph. If you change slightly this one to this one, then in that position in the stomach, here you absorb vitamin A, here you release vitamin D. When the scientists start understanding and go in the depth, now that the knowledge is released in the structure of the stomach, then they see how the fields are released from the stomach into the lymph.
Mr. Keshe. This is Francois. When you mentioned when you mentioned the pituitary gland, did you mean thyroid gland by any chance, or
You have parathyroid glands. Thyroid glands are not that mentionable. Most of the thyroid glands are to do with the emotional physicality. Parathyroid glands are to do with the physical part of the conversion of the fields.
So was it parathyroid gland or was it pituitary gland you mentioned?
It's parathyroid gland. Yes, these four are part of the physical structure conversion of the field forces. One of them does the field conversion for the matters of the emotion. One of them does for the matters of the storage. One of them does for the field transfer conversion for a matter state, solid state, to a plasma state. One of them is responsible for conversion of most of the free fields conversion into calcium only that supports the bone structure, because at any point if you don't have a bone structure there is no life. The four parathyroid glands have a specific function for a specific way in guaranteeing the conversion of the different fields to the GANs of the state of the matter which is needed. Then the thyroid gland is in a way operation of the brain controlling the physical operation of the totality. So when you go into the intestine, you understand how it is. So if you use a copper and you create a continuous copper, you're feeding your copper coil in a balanced state which is not needed, but the field transfer through link connection with the lymph converts and reaches and finds a conversion from the aluminium in the emotional part of the brain. That's why you don't touch aluminium. It's because of its gravitational magnetic field strength which causes this condition. It's not create. If you go back to part of the teaching, if you remember, I explained this a few weeks ago, where I explained when you look at the planet Earth and they tell you that they found a huge water reserve from millions of years ago in somewhere 2 or 10 kilometers down. I said no rain ever flowed down. The reason is pure is because the gravitational magnetic field of the Earth and its magma and its environment created in that cavity where the gravitational magnetic field is equal to H2O. That's how the water was created. You have the same principle when you use between this and the aluminium in the brain of the man. You have to be very careful. Aluminium, lead, there are a couple of other materials which have this property. They just happen in gravitational magnetic field of some of their isotopes. They create the matter state of themselves in a gaseous state, solid like a bone, in a given part of the brain of the man. They convert in field strength transfer. That's why better not to use aluminium, especially when it comes to application with the body and the food, because of the field transfer strength. And it's not all the aluminium isotopes, there's one or two of them. And it depends on the rate of the decay in one of the electrons in the boundary of the S1. Any other questions?
Yes, we have a question from Motion, I believe is the Motion Irfan. Could you want to go ahead?
Yes, Rick, thank you. Hello, Mr. Keshe. This is Mohsen from California. And yes. My question is that Would it be possible to use the field of plasma for traveling through the matter itself? Would it be possible to use it that way?
Of course, it'll be a gameplay. It'll be one of the first funds of plasma technology. You create, matter is very low, so we can create some noise in the background, please. So what you can do is, because the matter state is the lowest strength, we create a slightly higher, but enough to be able to understand the gravitational magnetic field positioning of the matter state. Even though to you, as we already done, you understand, in a molecular structure, we say the tightness. But even if you go close into this, this tightness has its own gravitational magnetic field positioning. It's not that they are compacted, they're still positioned, but in the tighter pack. So if you create in your system a field strength of this, you can go through the matter like that. Because when you enter it, they open up, this moves out, and the space becomes irrelevant. Because you dictate the positioning. This is part of the filtering system you can make with nanomaterials, like to filter kidneys, the work of the kidney. Problem? No more? You don't want to fiddle anymore? Very late. So, this is how you can do. You create the field gap. Now you understand the technology, you understand the magnetic positioning, you understand the structure of the field. You see how you can play with it. You don't go for the plasma itself, you go for the strength of the gap between the plasma. And if you create that gap, when you come in that gap, this has to find a new position, so you can go through it. We use this knowledge, this very, very easily nowadays, as I explained before, in the detergent technology. We nowadays, before, if you remember, 40 years ago, 30 years ago, we used to have to boil the cloth, that it loosens the fibers spacing in the cloth itself, that the detergent, the soap we used, could clean it, could actually interact with it and take it with itself. Now, they do a smaller dimension and they use the oil of orange. It does the same thing. It works on the same principle, but in the matter state. You use a smaller dimension to enter the gap. In the plasma, you use the strength of the fields to position yourself, and when you position, you can travel. In the plasma technology, in the field plasma technology, there is no state that the man cannot travel to, through, and from one to another. It's just you have to add the knowledge to understand how to do it.
Mr. Keshe, would it be possible using the plasma energy to actually reduce the size of the matter? For instance, if there is anything as massive and as big as planet of Earth, would it be possible to use the plasma energy to shrink it? Or vice versa, to make it bigger?
The thing is, if you take the energy in a plasmatic field from it, then its plasma reduces in size. Then, in the size of what I call the release. And then, its interaction decides. If you are thinking of making the Earth pocket size and go somewhere else and bring it out, you can do it, but you got to understand how and what is the composition of the field. This is what we discuss about viruses. And it's exactly the same. How do we shrink a virus and how does it become effective? We've seen it. We saw the report from, I just received a report from Ghana Water Research Center. It's amazing. It's downstairs if Benjamin is online, can show it to us. They've just completed E. coli testing with different waters of the rivers. You have the amino acid, Mr. Cohen. Then you have a plasma of the fields, which attaches due to the strength of one of these four elements or combination of them, that becomes supplier of energy into, and in a way, if you look at it, it takes over it. In the center, you have amino acid, but you have an energy package which is feeding it, and at the present science, in the world of medicine, we know how to destroy bacteria because we can play with the amino acid. But we haven't got enough knowledge to interfere with the extra energy, which is much stronger than amino acid. We call it viruses. Why the new plasma technology, the new GANS technology, is effective with the viruses, it's very simple. Because here you have a plasma, which is gaseous state or liquid plasma state or a field state. Now this has the spectrum of all the energies in a plasma. What do you do? This, in respect to the others, they start exchanging fields to find balance. In exchanging fields, they give their energy to the plasma and the space in between the plasma with the other matters. So what happens? You drain it. And gradually, it's still there. You didn't touch the amino acid, all you've done, you have depleted this energy. And that's how. In space, we have the same problem. In space, we don't have amino acid, we don't have bacteria. Bacteria are amino acid based according to the man's amino acid magnetic field, gravitational field strength. That's why they tell you viruses. We can handle bacteria, we can handle viruses, and we see it's good for E. coli, and we can use it for a disinfectant and the rest. It's just with the GANS, you create this condition. You can deplete, not deplete, bring balance between the fields in the environment, and then there is none. The same with the bacteria. Look at how the bacteria is created. There is still another form of plasma. When you put it with the GANS, depending finding the right GANS, you find out that you can use the GANS to change bacteria. This is what we're talking with the doctors, using the GANS water for aminization. Using the GANS unit, as is done by the TEPCO, infecting the mouse with the influenza, and then giving it a GANS and finding no side effects, no toxicity, and no influenza. That's how it works. That's why in a space you need it. You got to understand how to deplete it. So this goes with everything else. You can create, you can deplete, but then you dictate. In the discussion we had, and some of you have already been there, you use the patches. Your patches work exactly the same way. Why does your cancer patch or your whatever patch you use on your body works? This is exactly how it works. In your body, you put, let's say, this is the organ, whatever it could be, and you put a patch here, you put a patch there. Always say, don't use a single patch, always use double patch, it works more effective. Now, you have the GANS in here. This is the difference. GANS works on the gradient difference. And so what happens? You drain it very quickly. When you use your pens for inflammation, use two pens on either side. You'll see the difference much rapid. When you use a patch, use patches that you sandwich it, because now here you have some field losses. Here you have entrapped it in every shape or size it could be, you packed it. Because your transfer is energy. In time, if you go back a few weeks ago, I spoke about the time machine traveling in zero time by the strength of the field. That's exactly what you do. You find a position in the universe where you put yourself in the wind between the two, the direction you want to go, instant travel. You don't need to burn any fuel, you just, what do you call it? You become a sailor on the high sea. What do? You don't have an engine. How did man travel for centuries? With a curtain on a boat, flying over the oceans, as we call sailing it. Now, we have a knowledge in your systems, you can create the sails of the gravitational magnetic field of strength to get on the winds of the magnetic field of the universe. You don't need to burn anything. And if you get the strength right, you travel at the speed of it. If the wind is very soft, you float. If you get yourself in a high wind, you literally travel high speed across. Now, you have to transfer the knowledge in a different way, that the strength of the fields works in respect to the weakest to the strongest. The strongest always feeds to bring the weakest to his position. In the patches you made with the CO2 patches are the weak part. The virus is more intense, higher. So what does it do? The carbon and the oxygen is already part of your amino acid. So now you create the weaker point, the energy flows. If you look at it, in reality, I go back to it, 129. Your main reactor energy is your organ. Is the 129 reactor here in the center, because this is COHN plus some extra energy from whatever, and you have fixed this one to CO2 and this one to a CO2. What happens? 129 fed the other reactors, so it tries to give the energy to bring it to the balance. You find everything becomes the same. You want to take, you place a weaker field. You want to add, you put a higher field. This is why, if you look, I was explaining this yesterday to the doctor's teaching, the magnets are still here. How do we do it? We target it. If you want to do it, you actually can increase and directionalize. You do the same thing with your GANs, you do the same thing with your materials in your GANs containers. In my health units, I dictate the magnet, the strength of the magnet. Flat magnet or the ring magnet, the square magnet or rectangular magnet. Each one plays a game. I want to directionalize fields. I put it this way. I want to have equal what? Central different coming out of the plate. I use a square. I want to be flat enough to dictate the size of the plasma. I use a flat magnet. They're all here. You see it. This is a sphere one. This is a flat one, different thickness, different strength, and then what you decide is, am I playing north to north, or am I playing south to south, or am I playing north to south? And then, if it's a bigger strength compared to the smaller, and if it's going north to north, or is going in this shape in north to north. Where in fact here in the cup in the middle where the water is, I want this field strength. Then I know at this point I need the energy of hydrogen to be delivered. What do? I put liquid glue guns, which is high CH, which means it releases energy to it. I use a speck of nano copper oxide, or a speck of what I like to have, nano zinc. Now you target it. If you have some of the cups I've made past 5 or 10 years, if you open it, it will take you centuries to understand the principle. It's been, each one has been put together and it's been built. It takes a man's knowledge for years to understand what I built. But to me it's a second nature. I know how to push, how to build, and then because it's a plasmatic, it's left to the emotion of the man to receive or not to receive, because he still needs that emotional need to confirm his existence. That's why you build system and you find out people don't do anything in them. Because you give, but their expectation is, if I accept, I will not receive what I'm looking for, which is I want to take the brain. And then say, the system doesn't work with someone, the system works with everyone, but allows the priority of the emotion decision making. If you want to override it, load it up with what you call zinc ants and zinc material, and then you find out you can dictate any condition. And this is not the purpose. That's why we bring the freedom. It's there, if you want, you take. You can play, if you understand, a lot of things now that you play with the GANS material. The magnets are too weak, but you can use magnets to target, to confine, to hold. The same as you use the cores to hold the GANS or the plasma, liquid plasma, I've used for years magnets to do the same, because now within the structure, most of these, somewhere they have this, which connects to the blood of the man through the hemoglobin. You got to understand the technology in its true sense, in its totality. And then it's very easy to manipulate everything you need. You can walk a man out of cancer, if he wants it, and if he needs it to be, within seconds. But you take him back to a machine 10 times, because you are fixing the physicality, but the emotion needs a bit of feeding and thinking and talking and sorting itself out. Don't forget, the brain of the man has the power to reverse the cancer itself too, if he decides to. It doesn't need your system. It's more powerful than anything man can ever make, but it plays games with its own existence. Any other question?
Mr. Keshe, I have a question regarding the grounding of systems, or the idea of, I'm trying to reconcile the idea that people have, they call it grounding when people go with, for example, with bare feet and stand on the ground of the earth, and that sort of is a technique to ground yourself, as they call it. And at the same time, we have these, some systems have a grounding point that is used, and others use like the salt water as a as a place for the plasma to dump, essentially, or to be kind of grounded, I guess you would say. So can you explain a little bit about that? And obviously in space we don't have the Earth to ground to. So,
you can ground in the space easier than on Earth.
Okay, could you explain that a little bit then?
I do this a lot. My neighbors think I'm crazy sometimes, they look at me. I walk barefoot on the ground quite a lot. I find a lot of pleasure with it because I receive what I don't have physically and I give what I need. I enjoy lying on the ground quite a lot, especially when the time you need to concentrate. It brings you and you give and you take to bring balance between the physicality and the motion. The earth works the same as the I just explained with the magnets and the two pads. It releases fields in the matter state of what it has and what you need and what you don't want and what you give. People who would sleep on the high towers, you find different behavior than people who sleep in the fields. And every now and then we need it. We need to exchange fields with in a way to bring balance to our life in the physical condition. The dumping is a surplus energy which you put into a system which you don't need. But with what you call walking barefoot or even you can use your head, you can use your hands to bring balance. You find, I do this without noticing, but I know why I do it. I tend to just in the time to stick my hands to the wall and I put my head against the wall. If you put your head against the wall where it's a concrete, you don't get much. But if you use a brick or what you call it, a stone wall, you find you get different energies. You tune into the environment. It's a technique used for centuries, for those who understand it. I explained this transfer of energy even a couple of weeks ago. When you hold one of the pen pens in your hand, you don't direct it. You take and you give at the balance what you need. This balancing is essential. It's the filtering of emotion fields, not so much in the matter state. And you find out, for example, when you lie on the sand on the beach, you discharge different in different sands. If you go to a white sand, or you go to a volcanic sand, the discharge is very different. You see different behavior because you get rid of certain strength fields. And it's essential. It's got to be part of the life of every man in being able to bring balance. And it's done for those who understand it, do it quite often. I walk quite often barefooted on the ground in the garden because it allows me to transfer what is I need and what I don't need back in the physical level. In the time I can't solve things, I just lie down on the floor. It doesn't matter where it is because you receive and you give what you don't want. The dumping is part of the process in a way. You give what you don't need and it's taken, but you give to the higher gravitational fields. It has a huge application in space. If you know how to dump, where to dump, it's a very effective way for discharge of energies, especially if you have like meteorites ahead of you. You have areas where you don't want to destroy. By dumping, you saturate. It's a huge application. You release, and exactly what I explained with the washing. You release so much energy that the gravitational magnetic field, the strength of the cells of the structure increase so much that the gap, the positioning increases and you can go through it. And you only do it by dumping. You just dump surface energy into a given area. You carry, a spaceship is known to carry high energy packets just for this job. It's not a missile. If you use it on Earth, you will not see a thing because it literally dissolves like a sugar in a hot water. It's very, very easy. This is what I said. We can take radar satellites out in no time. We don't destroy them, we just saturate them with energy. They're not even there to do their job. Dumping, and I slowly start teaching you about. If you notice, even today, I start teaching techniques, not systems. And this, those who understand, using these techniques can do a lot with it. In the past 2 or 3 weeks, I start teaching techniques, not technology, not systems. Because you have all this. And now, having the techniques how to create wind, how to dump, how to create motion, using systems, how to communicate without having a system. How would you call from the other side of the universe to a man on the earth that I'm stuck, I've run out of everything, can I have help? You can wait there, man might get there in a few billion years, or instantaneously we can reach to us. And this is one of them. Dumping is the way you, what you need, but you can hold it and control it or share it. And use it when you need it. You usually use high, unbalanced field plasmas for dumping or storage of energy. Usually, isotopes of matter element which have very low radioactive base but a very high cosmic radiation base. And they compensate for one for the other and they store energy or they store or the capacitors of the of the energy, and lead is one of them. You get a chance, walk on the ground with different sands, you see the feeling, it changes. You walk on different grounds, you take different feelings. You sleep on the different ground. That's why human race is becoming more and more detached society-wise. Because we sleep on the mattresses, which is all predetermined with all sorts of rubbish in it. The humanity stayed more or less the same. When you understand, you are connected to the point of this your own creation. I was explaining very recently, not recently, some time ago, that most of the diseases man is suffering from is from the mattresses we sleep on. The ions, the materials which is used, contaminated materials which doesn't match our body. And we transfer energy continuously. We transfer energy to our environment and these places are fixed. The environment where you, where we live, where we live, we interact with. Try to sleep in the room which is full of nano-coated zinc, and I will tell you what it does to you in 2 days' time. You will walk loving every creature in this universe, because emotionally you're satisfied. It reaches the point that you receive what you need.
Any other Well, Ronnie had asked earlier in the chat, can humans create and control fields without having any GANs or GANs water around, as the human is in the plasma state and contains almost all material such as CO2 and copper oxide and CH3, etc. And he went on a little more.
Of course you can.
He's wondering about how to control the rotation of fields and create different conditions. Are they connected to different emotions?
You got to learn it first. You got to learn yourself. You got to understand your own being. Then you can create anything you want and you can let others see it. Or you feed it yourself. It needs a lot of discipline and understanding what to release. And depends what you want, who you want to be the audience of you, what you create. You can hold your hands and play all sorts of games. I've seen this sitting here when we were talking about it, and they push and they move. And you can do standing here and look into the sky and says, oh, you want to see a meteorite? There it is. Because you create a condition on the vision of the man and with the matter in the state. It's very easy. But first you have to understand what you want to do with it. What's the purpose of it? You hold your hand, we talked about this last year, and in respect to what Caroline said, to hold your hand and you create your own aura, or create your own plasma ball. It needs a lot of understanding of your own strength. Any other questions?
Yes, Mr. Cash, this is again Mohsen from California. Mr. Cash, you were always mentioning the creating a matter from plasma is an art. I was wondering if you can explain a little bit more about this subject.
You can create matter out of plasma when you understand the field. Your is open. When you understand at what point the field, the strength reduces enough to be at a matter state. When you have a plasma goes through its own release of energy to its environment. If you control the reduction to the point that you decide the rate of reduction, then you can create anything between your hands. You can put your hand out with looking at it with your brain. You can create a field that at the point of the hand, the energy from your brain reduces so much that it becomes gold in your hand and everybody can see it. So you put the skin, the strength of the feeling through the motion of your hand, which comes from the brain itself, in a way through your blood cells and nervous system, at the limit of gold. Now you want bread, will be bread. You have to dictate the boundary of the strength. And with your emotion, you have already dictated it, with your hand, you dictate the position. A lot of people have done this, but it's understanding how much you release at what point. You put your hand out 20 centimeters, you get no bread, you bring it 10 centimeters, you get bread. And you can actually physically touch it, physically give it to the people eat it, it's bread. Christ done that, bless his name, two or three times, but the people didn't see it. This is my body, this is my blood. That's how it was done. Intention of the thoughts brought the physicality of the entity. Any other question?
There was a question from Monique in the chat about the, again, going back to the aluminum coils for the MagGrab boxes. She's concerned that you'll be living in the field of the aluminum or the zinc at home, and that might not be good. Is that the way it works? The way I understand it is the field is mainly contained within the immediate area of the coils and so on, with the MagGrab unit itself, more than the health unit, which is designed to actually transfer, you know, has a greater gradient between the two sets of coils. That's a different situation. Can you explain that, Mr. Keshe? Is that
With the health units, you use the field. When you use the MagGrab units with aluminium, you're open to the space to take. It's a different thing. You sandwich the body in those plates. It has nowhere to go. It has nothing to interact with, in a way. But when you have it in the house as a single core, whatever, you share with the rest of the environment in the room. It's a big difference.
Right, thank you. Okay.
If you understand this process of containment in let's say in the nuclear disasters or the nuclear power stations, you can use this knowledge very effectively to contain all the radiation. We've seen with TEPCO the conversion of energy, but with understanding this technology, this containment with the field plasma, you can do wonders. You can contain any radioactive leakage from any source. Just using the fields, you don't need the containers. Any other questions?
I've got a couple of viewers. I think Monique might want to speak. Bring her in, and Gladstone Watt also. And there's someone, KKKKO.
Hello.
Hello.
Hello, this is Torbjørn from Norway with Monique.
Oh, okay, hi.
Hello. I have a very precise, excuse me, Mr. Keshe?
We are listening.
Yes, yesterday I received a patient with cancer. He doesn't have much hope for the doctors. And I gave him 40 minutes between the walls. Although he have a cell, what we call here in Norway is a self poison. It's through the blood, poison through the blood, for cancer treatment. And he's about to choose plasma rather than treatment, and he felt that something really good was going on, but he was very, very tired, and so he spent first 10 minutes between the walls, and then he got out to breathe some air, and then he got in again, and
so I'm going to stop you there. Have you found yourself a doctor to work with?
He's His friend has been following him for 9 years, but no doctors, no.
I'm not going to answer you till you find yourself a doctor.
But well, actually,
I'm very, very, very precise. If he was for yourself, I advise you. And I've told you before, find yourself a doctor that you can monitor things.
Yes, we took a film of the visit.
Doesn't matter. You gotta get yourself a doctor. Work with a doctor. You can join in with Dr. Rodriguez in US or other doctors, Dr. Fashid in Paris in Middle East or other doctors. But do not do these things just because you build a ball. You're doing things, and I explained that to you before.
Yes, yes.
We've got number of doctors. We have number of Italian doctors who are joining the teaching. Use them, explain them the condition and whatever, and let them advise you.
Mm-hmm.
You become X-ray technician, but not the X-ray doctor, not the radiologist.
I understand.
You have to understand this. A lot of people are building these systems and using it because people feel good, but it has to be done correctly. And I advise you, in Sweden or in Norway, there are doctors who work around the foundation. Take your system to them and work with them.
But I have a question. I gave him liquid plasma copper based and liquid plasma zinc based. Two glasses. And I have a report that he's feeling better, but he's saying that his relaxation is feel differently.
I don't know. I prefer you to discuss this with the doctor.
Yeah.
I explained this to you before, and I'll go the same way. You build a system, and you can put it in the middle of a square. People can walk in it and tell them this does the cancer and this does that. But it's to understand what the process is and what it does, and if it does, which way it goes. And this discussion we had with you before. You build beautiful system, you're very active, but please get yourself a doctor you can work with. Write at doctors at Keshe Foundation at the Spaceship Institute or keshefoundation.org and work with one of the doctors. They work with you remote, it's not a problem, but you work supervised. You understand what's happening, please.
Yes, I'm working with Klaus.
Try to get yourself fixed because it's important. And then, whatever you find out with the doctor's supervision, you can add to the knowledge. You're quite welcome. You have to do it this way.
Yep.
Another, everybody does everything else. When you come on, then you bring a lot of things on the table, which we have to understand. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Keshe.
Thank you. Any other question?
I think there was someone called Gladstone Watt who had a question. And do you want to unmute you and see what you have to say there? Hello?
Hello, Mr. Keshe.
Yes. Hello.
Hello. It's Gladstone Watt from New Zealand.
Yes.
Just a question. I've, on the health side, I've linked up about 7 McGrath coils and linked it through to my roof. And I have a metal roof, and I've got quite a large energy field, which is slowly coming through the ceiling and entering my room.
Why have you done that for? Are you trying to fly or take the whole house to fly?
No, it's just the reaction, the energy fields of the McGrath I was trying to work on. It's just an idea. Just a wee bit of feedback would be quite good.
What do you feel in the house?
It just seems a wee bit calmer. Initially you said with zinc and you know, you can get an energy field around that. I suppose it's like a large capacitor. I'm just trying to get the plasma to...
The point is, how is it a stacker of seven on top of each other?
No, it's in series, yes, from one coil to the next.
Where is the magnetic coil of the last one connected to? You know, when you go from gravitational to magnetical to gravitational, and you have one end which is gravitational in your hand, and you have one end which is a magnetic coil of the seventh coil, and you have the gravitational of the first coil. Where are these two connected?
They just go from gravitational to magnetical. It's the
Okay, I understand. Yeah. But what is the first gravitational connected to? And what is the last magnetical connected to of yours?
I'll have to, I haven't got a photo with me actually. It's difficult to are you asking whether how it's connected to mains or?
No. You have a stacker in your hand, yeah? You build a stacker, seven of them.
Yes, yeah.
And you have connected them. When you connected the stacker, seven of them together, you have two ends in your hand.
Yes, I've connected them all in series, just like
I understand that. The seven is connected in series one to another, yes?
Yes.
At the end of the day, you have seven of them on top of each other.
Yes.
The last coil, the seventh one, has a magnetical coming out, a wire. Yeah?
Yes.
Where is that connected to?
I've actually put that through a single cable and gone to my roof.
Where is the first coil gravitational connected to?
The capacitor.
And what is the end of the capacitor, the gravitational of the capacitor connected to?
To the neutral.
Stick it to the antenna of the house, or stick it to the antenna, nano-coated antenna, and leave it that way. And then tell me how you feel in about 2 weeks' time. But keep your magnetical connected to your roof.
Okay.
Because this way you receive energy from the environment, from the cosmos, which is a massive amount, and then you bring it down and you connect it to the magnetical which covers the whole house. The feeling should be different and the emotion should be much, much different.
Thank you. Thank you very much for that. Thank you.
We do this now in some trials. You have to find a point to feed your gravitational. If you connect your gravitational to Earth, you're taking energy from the Earth, which you don't do much with and feed it back. Take it from the space and feed it to the house, and then you see the difference.
Oh, thank you very much. Yeah, I had an idea that it's just a massive collector, so you've just confirmed my thoughts.
Use a chicken mesh, it'll be fantastic. I've done this because I can tell you this way. Get yourself a zinc chicken mesh, chicken zinc. Wire.
Yes.
What we call galvanized zinc chicken wire, nano coated. And then connect your gravitational to this zinc mesh. You'll have fantastic time.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Any other question, or shall we call it a day? I have, we forgot to tell you one thing. We promised you, we're going to release you this week the 10 euro per Maghreb unit for Italian people. We will announce, we'll release this maybe tomorrow or Monday on the website. But there is a further development in the communication with the bank, which has to be added to by tomorrow. We see they have made a huge move in the process of getting these units as fast as possible into the Italian market. So if you're Italian, hopefully we everything should be done on our side here on the website of the cash. It's called cashfoundation.org. Am I correct, Fabio? You'll find a code reference and the bank reference. We have already informed the bank that rope people who call the bank to call us terrorists and everything else, and we are fraudulent. So we are waiting for you to call the bank, please, because we are looking for your numbers and your access and your emails, because the Italian police will take immediate action against you. We are waiting for you. We inform you beforehand. You don't walk into a trap. Once we release the bank details, please, what you did with the other banks, call them this time. We'll put you in the hand of the Italian police force and the Carabinieri. They're waiting for you. On the other hand, please use the system wisely. We will deliver according to our Italian production manufacturing. The system is at 10 euro for a Maghreb system. And it's for 120 installments, which is 10 years. The system carries other pieces which is put in, including the interest for the bank and the transportation and the, what you call, the BTV or the taxes, local taxes. And you can still buy the units directly from the foundation if you want to pay for it. And as of next week, 1st of June, we withdraw the 300 contribution from the Maghreb systems. So the Maghreb systems come to the standard 499, and the structure stays the same. You can go to the Italian bank, give the reference code number. It'll be going through a setup of the company which we use here in Italy for the acceptance and the guarantee. As usual, within 90 days, the systems will be delivered. We are more or less up to date with all our systems. I was told, I received a text somewhere that the Maghreb unit, what do you call it, the pads are delayed by 2-3 days, it'll be out. So as of by the end of this month, hopefully we have no backlog of units, and anything which comes in, it will be delivered on time within the 90 days, but we do it prior because there's a stock of materials. We can meet the first 10,000-20,000 demands immediately in 30 days, 60 days time. The people who are working and have been applying for the what we call the test with the plasmas, with the GANs, these emails will go out to you this week. Please fill in the form, the agreement, send it back to us, it's all done. And within next 2 to 3 weeks, we start hopefully releasing the materials for you and the way to be used. We have slightly changed the structure because of the addition to the knowledge. Some of the systems, like for the eye drop, we have changed it in a different way. And the one which is for the the skin, we have released it in a different format. So everything should be on its way. Once we receive your agreements, send it back to us, you become part of the trial process. Any other question?
Not seeing anything. There's a question, can we pay by credit card rather than a bank transfer?
It'll be next 30 days, yes. We closed our business with PayPal, and we, as we said, in June, we closed all our activities in Belgium. The reason for it is, we tell you in advance, the nation of the Belgium soon will not exist. It'll divide into the French and the Dutch. So we are wiser we move before they do, because we see the process coming up. It'll be shocking to some of those who call themselves Belgium. But the state of Belgium will not exist in a very short time, because you will understand it very, very soon why we are moving out, because there will not be a state called Belgium. And we're not predicting, we know what is happening in the background. And as of June, we close every activity in Belgium. And the new banking system will carry the credit card facilities and all the facilities which you need to pay by card or whatever guarantees you use. It'll be, again, our Italian banking system, and it'll be done most probably when we're in China, we open the same structure in China banking system. Cash Foundation China will support massive part of the program. We disclose it when we arrive.
Okay, thank you, Mr. Keshe. I think that
Let me explain to you why we need it. Because euro and dollars are on a very loose foot, and the Chinese currency is solid. And this way, we guarantee we support and stay with the nations which are correct in their conduct. So we move a lot of our work into China. Carry on.
Okay, is there anything else you'd like to talk about, Mr. Keshe? Or another question, how do we get included in the trials and receive an email for the application for the trial of the supplements? I believe they just have to purchase the particular products first, right?
And then they just go on a trial. You don't purchase a product. This 120 euro for the trial is for creating the information. As I said, we in time it becomes part of the blueprint. You can produce it yourself, but we're setting a structure to collect data for international application that we set up. We don't work like a FDA doing trials and covering up. We have brought a lady, some of you might know, Sabrina has taken over to putting all the testimonials, all the emails, all the correspondence for all the health section. Section for the doctors' testimonials stays private for the doctors only. But the public testimonials and the communication for the GANS trials will be handled by Sabrina. She's taking over from this week. Everything gets set up for her by the webmasters. And you just sign in, you fill in the form, the agreement. I finished the agreement approval last night, so it'll go out hopefully this week. Once Sabrina takes position, all the emails will go from the banking side to there, and you receive it, you fill it in, you send it back. Once you receive it, then the products or the facilities will be released to you from Tokyo. Most of the materials for the first 30 days will be made in Tokyo, and after that we go, if I'm correct, Giovanni, we go from Italy. So we are getting license for both sides that we can supply either way. If you are a Japanese citizen and you live in Japan, hopefully you can get the full material supplements. Even we try to get you the waters for decontamination of your lands and decontamination of the house where you're contaminated with Fukushima. If you live around Fukushima area in the zone where it was radioactively, heavily radioactively contaminated, in the next few weeks we release materials for this environment, especially in what you call it in Japan. This as we speak now, what's the time now? 11 o'clock. Test has started in Tokyo. They started about 9 o'clock this morning, and once they're happy with their tests, the results, and everything else, then in Tokyo, in Japan, you can start receiving the supplements for the contamination from radioactive materials of Fukushima directly in the, as a public, as a, what do you call it, as a substance within there. You should be able to buy it off the shelf within the next few weeks. But if you go to the website, you can purchase, and you will send the application form. It took us some time to get it legally sorted. It's done now, and we started from this week. Next week, you'll start receiving the emails.
Okay, Mr. Keshe, there is one last question maybe you can address, which is from Gladstone Watt. He mentions he's been experimenting with treating human waste, and he has a few samples and trying to change the condition. Human waste. And can Mr. Keshe give me any info on where to go forward with it? I think there has been some test results, haven't there, on the E. coli testing for with the Gans material, Gans water.
I don't understand. Can you explain?
Well, he's talking about experimenting with treating human waste. And so I'm assuming that E. coli might be part of the testing that you'd want to do to try to reduce E. coli, for example.
We have. Benjamin, I don't think. Benjamin is in the background. Benjamin, are you there?
Don't see him in the
panelists. Just 1 second.
He's around and can put his hand up, then I can recognize you as a viewer.
Could be. Fabio, could you please, can you bring my computer back from the office? This data we received yesterday from Atomic Energy Water Sections of the Ghanaian Atomic Energy Government of Ghana, because it's important how it works. There is some more analysis going on with it. The waters, E. coli, effectively can be reduced or totally taken out by use of CO2 or copper oxide liquid plasma. Now we have the data, because what they did, the authorities in Ghana, it's a huge problem because a lot of people do everything in the rivers, they kill the animals and they clean themselves and everything else. And they did a test with this E. coli. And I received a test yesterday. We received a lot of information now coming through Ghana Atomic Energy, because they've seen the work of the technology and they see it as a very easy way, the cheapest way, literally at no cost, they're changing the course. They will be releasing next week, hopefully we have gone online, they have produced the first soaps, which can literally eliminate all bacteria. It's better than any detergent they've seen, thank you very much. And it's a way, it's the way they've been working on it, they've developed it, and I can read it to you. They've used often river E. coli on the raw without the treatment, was brought to zero from 46. Pra rho was 7. Treated came to 2. Brim rho was 19. Brought to 8. Shemes was 19. Brought to 1. And Ghanaian standards and international standard is 0. So we've seen literally, except one case, which we want to know why Brim is gone to less than half, but doesn't go to 0. What is the content of the river? Which we might have to add more gas, liquid, water, plasma liquid of the CO2 or copper oxide to be able to bring that to 0. So hopefully the Water Research Institute, the Council of Science and Industrial Research in Ghana, which has produced this paper here, is signed and sealed by the head of the department. That is means official test results, we received it. So it is backed by Ghana Atomic Energy Council. So we know this will be used in the coming time, in the next few weeks. I have set up a process that will test this in China. It's very effective to cleaning up the rivers. The problem with it is that we create a condition that we can get rid of the E. coli, but we do not endanger the life of the other creatures in the river. This is important. We have to find a balance, and from the what you want to use for human waste, the gas of CO2 and copper oxide works, but with for the total elimination of the what you call the E. coli. We know from Sri Lankan South University, E. coli with the gas water totally annihilates. It does not exist. It just drains the energy out of the plasma of the protein. So we see the application, and we can see how things can develop, and by they're going into the methodological of measure by weight and by milliliter per sample. So by changing the sample from more gas of copper oxide, you can eliminate totally all the bacteria, any bacteria in the cleaning process. But you have to consider, if you use it as a source for the in the rivers, you have to reconsider the position that we create a life condition that the energy balance between the copper oxide allows the life and the existence of the fish and the other animals in the river. So what we're looking at is a combination of CH3, CO2, zinc oxide, and a small amount of copper oxide. So we know it reduces to a limit of safe, but it does not destroy. By adding the understanding the process, you add CH3 into the river to allow life. But on the other hand, you take energy from what is above carbon, which is the plasma of the virus. I explained this earlier on today. So you try to keep in connection with the human life, with the marine life, but anything above it, you take away with the copper oxide. So you don't endanger life. If you use only copper oxide, gas or a liquid plasma, you take all the energy out. This way, with a balanced field, as you're using a single plasma, everything looks after together. You have to start thinking universal, not to just to achieve one. You have to see what are the other side effects, what are the other conditions it creates, and we'll see how it can be put together. You've got, when you deal with the environmental conditions, you have to understand you don't go just to achieve what you want to achieve. Because this way, to get rid of something, you destroy the others. You look, what are the parameters, what are the things that are involved, what are the animals, creatures are involved in the whole thing. You support their life, and you take what you don't need out of the circulation, which is not good for you, but you still allow the life to exist. If you understand the totality of what even we taught earlier on today, it's very important. I was explaining this yesterday on the table to Giovanni. I've got to find it, then you see it exactly where we go. And let me go back to it. I don't know where it was, but let's go and find it. Because it's important, you understand what I'm talking about in a minute. Ah, there it is. You see, this is a virus at the moment, a threat. But if you take its energy from it as a virus, see what you got in your hand. You have amino acid. This is a food. This is how the situation changes. You change a virus, a dangerous position, by using the appropriate GANS transfer of energy to a life-giving thing. This is what we've done in TEPCO in Tokyo. We use the radioactive material to create gold, which you saw it in the presentation. You don't destroy anything with this new technology. You find out how, by creating a condition, you allow the normality, but what it brings more on the table. Here you have bacteria, you have the virus. You take the energy from it. Inside it sits a vast amount of energy. This itself is food. You created, you spent so much time to create it. But if you can use this in conjunction in the right way, you create new life in the water. Not everything is bad, it's just understanding how to use it to your advantage and what it leaves behind. A lot of viruses which are connected to the amino acid, the what you call, of the human being, can be taken away, and then that amino acid is a huge, vast amount of energy available to man. It's like eating a beef. But this time, the energy inside could be much more. Because, don't forget, by being connected to the virus, the amino acid has received new levels of energy, it's fully charged. Don't look at always getting rid of, see what is left, what brings as a gift. In dissemination plants, in reprocessing plant, in environmental cleaning plant, always look what it gives you, not what it destroys that you are happy with. Because if you can see what it gives you, then you can use it, that you path, you set the path in a very peaceful way, that the coexistence stays for everything, but what it brings benefit to you at that time. In environmental pollutioning, when you clean, when you want to clean the air, you create gravitational magnetic field of the matter, of the environment which you want to clear, and what is left with it? What can you do with what is left? It's a lot of assets. It's a lot of materials which you can use for a lot of things if you understand what you receive. Come out of the mindset of destroying or getting rid of, and come into the mindset of what benefit does it bring me and the humanity? How can I use the new condition to benefit, have benefit from it, to the advantage of us? Then you find out you think totally different. You see the operation of the GANs and the plasma totally different way than just trying to destroy as has been the pattern. Any other question?
We have one here, Mr. Keshe. It's actually from Sandy. I'm not sure why she's being a bit shy, but
Sandy being shy.
Hard to believe. But she's asking, please describe a situation in which you see the Universal Council would be involved in. How do you see the Universal Council working?
Well, she's the Secretary General, she can answer it herself. I'm a foot soldier.
One way I've seen it working is in subgroups in Facebook to address different people's concerns. Like
this is Facebook subgroups are set up by Caroline. Caroline, being a member of the council, she set up the Universal Council, is in bracket KFSSI, and because there's so much coming in, they start dividing it into the sections which everybody can take part in coming with positive ideas to solve different problems. They're now, I heard yesterday they're talking about the veterinarians for the animals. We've seen Dr. Rodriguez having that dog. We have doctors, but we have no vets to look after the interest of the animals. So now they've set up veterinarian side, they've set up another one for the doctors. People can come in with positive ideas. The work of the council is the progress towards a peaceful application of the technology and bringing peace. And a number of council members who are there understood, work in that direction. So what they do, what their job is not to look what the conflict has brought or how we can fight this to get what we want. The council members will work in the direction of this is another alternative way which harms no one. This is a way the council will work. We work on a plan or a direction that we look at a positive, peaceful application of the technology. As I said before, we can bring a lot of ways and knowledge into not fighting, but bringing solutions. And then when we bring solutions, don't fight because we brought the solution, it has to be our way. We bring a solution and it's for the souls to accept the work of the solution. This is the way it has to be. We put the wrongs on the table, but with the solution of right, but not blaming for what's gone wrong.
Mr. Keshe, may I read the first rule to be the a member of the Universal Council that I believe you've put in the message?
Please.
It says, the Universal Council member should shine like the light of the Creator, to be the source of light for other souls and radiate the light of the beauty of the Creator, and have and try to reach all attributes of the soul of the Creator. In time, creatures of the universe see this light and not the physicality of the man. The attributes of the Creator have been stated in many scriptures of the man in the past.
I think that answers the totality of it. This is the rules and the conditions, and maybe this is a rule for humanity as a whole, but we wait and see in time will mature. You would like to read the second?
Okay, it says, secondly, you are through your soul a member of the council. Shall I continue?
Yes, it's already.
The members of the council can't announce themselves as a member of the council unless it is announced and registered under the council's panels, and no members of the council can ever speak as themselves being a member and influencing their opinion or words. At this point, they immediately lose their seat in the council and a new member can stand for the position. Those who try to show that they are better servants of humanity, they do not stand a chance to take a seat in the council. That's an interesting, I'll just say that again. Those who try to show that they are better servants of humanity, they do not stand a chance to take a seat in the council. So it goes on, selection of the soul of the council comes from service through giving from the soul and not by talk or physical actions. That's the end of that transmission.
The process is very simple. A lot of people who were in Dubai and announced themselves they want to be a council, then they went out to use it to dictate. And immediately they lost their seat. And we're looking, if you're any speaking language, will be announced by before September. The languages which we have filled in as member of the councils. And if you are of nature of the soul of serving humanity, you can come to the Rome meeting and stand for the language, the mother language, not the language you spoken, the mother language which you speak for the members of that community. And when it's filled up, or there is a place for the soul standing, it's for you to work with the same soul as it is the council to strengthen the work of that language. So we don't take away, there's somebody else, there is no job. You add to the totality to strengthen and spread the, what we call, the peaceful application of the technology with the governments, with the institutes, with teaching, and in that process we go very far. Couple of governments have already understood and will understand the process, and we are in that path of working very rapidly. Use of the technology, and you will see that these leaders will stand as members of the councils themselves, because they change the course of humanity as a position they have, and they'll serve better than anybody else because they've done it. We've seen this with one world leader in the past, and I mentioned it before. Gorbachev is the only world leader in the past which put the nation, the soul of his nation, ahead of his position. And as the head of the USSR, he submitted his nation to freedom of his soul. It'll take a lot of men to do that. It needs a lot of freedom of physicality to let such a position as one of the most powerful men in the world for a nation to have its freedom. And he's still among us. He's sick, but he's still among us. Any other question?
Mr. Keshe. Sandy, I'm not being shy now. If people are interested in becoming a part of the council, do they have to go to Rome, or can they just submit an intention?
We are trying. I looked at this. I seen your email, and we can organize for people who cannot be there for whatever reason, or they don't want to be there. We open a Zoom channels onto the conference. Even the member of the councils, we allow them to attend if they want, but you can stay in your own country, because when you're on the planet Zeus, traveling in a space, you come in a council, but you're there with your soul. So we allow people to put their name up very soon, once we set the structure, to be the member of the council for their spoken language. And you'll be given a, what we call Zoom link with the other member of the councils, and you can attend or set up your own meeting in your own native language or in your mother tongue, and you'll be announced, and the people can come to you, or you can go to the people to encourage to deliver the process of the peace. And we are receiving in a, we are coming to a position that financially the foundation, through different structures, can support not a peace movement, but delivery of the tools of peace. In the coming week, coming weeks, you will see what we mean with this. We are still looking for a council from Hebrew language. If you are of a Jewish descent, you speak a fluent Hebrew, join the council, because there is a lot you can do with us, with the Muslim Arab members of the council for development of the peace in the Middle East. I know we have a large number of Jewish listeners in the background. If you see your soul in a position to be able to use the technologies to bring peace, you don't need to come to the conference. You send, you open the channel, you know where it is, to represent yourself to be the Hebrew-speaking member of the council. And then we have a lot to talk about. The same goes with other cultures and other languages. It'll be very difficult for a lot of council members from Africa to attend the meetings because of the situation, getting visa, being there. You can represent yourself, you can nominate yourself as a member of the council, you'll be given the same facility as the English or French speaking member of the council, and we support you where you are, and you can communicate with the others, but understand your own position. Being a member of the council from any African language, or American, or English, or Chinese, does not give none of them or you any superiority or inferiority. You're all equal, because you work through your soul, and not through the state of a nation, which has been the cause of all the problems. So we need, we'll announce in time, now we have two full members, full-time members in the background, Ali as an ambassador, and Sandy as a, what they call, the head of the Keshe Foundation organization on the Universal Council, and we add to this as we go along, as is needed. They'll collaborate with you to give all the facilities equal to all the people who wanted to be the member of the council. We announce the council in next 30 days, 60 days, when it's all settled. If you were in Dubai and you stood to be a member of the council and still of the same ethos, you have been sent an email in the past 7 days. Respond to the email and the process starts. Three people who stood have already been themselves, stood themselves down by their behavior, as we've seen on the internet and what we see. We check number of things, and we don't look for what is in the background. We check how you behave from the day you become or stood to become a member of the council. If it's just to be there, or is it there to serve? And we've seen two German speaking Spanish, they've been withdrawn by the council, they will not accept the position, and one has been from Norway.
We do have a someone on live stream who's been around, Abby Ovitsky. She is saying she will be in Rome. She speaks Hebrew, and she invites Israelis now. She's Jewish, she says, and she would like to do it, and fluent in Hebrew.
Contact the council.
Okay.
Universal Council has its own website, its own link. And in a way I can tell you, it works as you want it. It works if the message is peace. If you listen, shalom, salam is all the same meaning.
And she's asking what link would be the way to get in touch.
Sandy, you're there.
Okay, sandy@spaceshipinstitute.org.
Okay, I hope that doesn't create too much of a flood of emails, but just the right amount.
It's good. It's for her, not for us. She can read them. We get enough of it, keeps her busy for a while. Any other question? Do you support of the council? You don't need to be a member of the council to support the council work. We work all as a team, irrespective of position and time. But it has to be positive. Any negativity, we will not respond to. Find a position where we do not interfere with the work of the physicality, but we interact and elevate the soul of the man in any shape or form. In Hebrew, there is a word, and that word has been taken out of the language. In Arabic, it's the same word, but it has to be taken out of the language when you become a member of the council. In Arabic, they call it ajab, and in Hebrew, they call it kweb, which means a foreigner, a non-believer. So, in bringing peace, we come to a point to understand that the work of the council is the unification of the soul of the man. Thank you very much for today. We finish at 12 o'clock. We have some work to do in the background. Is there any questions or we call it a day?
The only other thing is Brett mentions a couple of email addresses, and he wants to ask you if he can announce the one for the Universal Council at the Keshe Foundation email address. Well,
You are the webmaster, why should I do it? As you know, we have two webmasters, Stanley and Vince, and they got their hands full with their own bits. And it's getting close. We are looking to add a couple of Chinese webmasters in the coming time while we are in China. And to amalgamate the work of the foundation as one team.
I can put up the a screen share of the
Would you like to announce it for the ones who listen?
Yeah, I'll announce it. I got my microphone here. So it's universalcouncil.keshefoundation.org.
But Universal Council has its own .org website too. Am I correct? or has it been set up yet? Ah, okay. Universal Council has its own webmaster section, which is Ali, and in time they'll give you all the access to it.
It's universalcouncil.info.
Pardon?
Universalcouncil.info.
Dot info. Ah, okay. Thanks very much, Brad. Thank you indeed. We'll see you next week. We've been told we'll see strange things by one of the masters of the knowledge seekers. He's working on it. And we will have some communication with Ghana, because there's some developments there. Hopefully we have Benjamin online. And cases with the doctors in Nigeria.
No, there was a bit of a cutout there, Mr. Keshe, if you could...
What I said, we're hoping that Alex can tell us more about the application of the plasma liquid, which is getting tested in Nigeria with the malaria with the doctor. We hopefully have some news from Alex on that one. And we'll see how we go into the next steps. Thank you very much for today. Okay. It's the first time we close at our 3 hour promised time.
Yes.
Very unusual.
Congratulations.
Sometimes I look at the live stream and YouTube, say 5 hours, 4 hours. I said, we started this for a couple of hours, 3 hours was a good time. I used to get nagged by Rick, Mr. Keshe, you're reaching the 3 hour. It's the first time you're back into normality. Thank you very much for all your support. And again, please, my call goes on the Chinese Keshe Foundation. As we are working so closely with your government, please, all communication, all work of the Keshe Foundation between the government of China and the Keshe Foundation goes to Professor Zhu of USPC. He is the head of the Keshe Foundation, appointed head of the Keshe Foundation, agreed both by us and the Chinese government. All the collaboration, all the work, every research you do, all the funding which has been raised by the Chinese government and others, will go through Professor Zhu. He's a highly respected scientist in China and trusted both by us and by the government. Please direct and put all your efforts in that direction in China till we arrive, and then we merge the two as one organization between the Keshe Foundations and the Chinese government. Thank you very much.
Okay, thank you very much, Mr. Keshe. That was another good show here today.
Do I get paid?
Yes, twice as much as last week.
Which was nothing.
Well, yes, well, it's still twice as much.
Thank you very much. Thank you indeed.
You get paid in gratitude from people around the world. I see in the live stream there's a stream of thank you, thank you, thank you, thanks. Thank you, Mr. Keshe, and thanks all, and what a great gathering again. Thanks all, and great, and etc. It just goes on. It's amazing.
Thank you very much indeed. All the best. See you next Tuesday.
Okay, yes. And that will bring it to a close, the 115th Knowledge Seekers Workshop for May 25th, 2016. And as always, and throughout the universe, thank you everybody for attending. Okay, well, and the...
Thank you, Rick. Q&A is still at the normal time in about 2 hours.
Thank you, Rick.
All right. Thank you. Thank you.